knowing my next guest spent time holding down the fort at the Capitol to stop the president from making any more of these controversial moves. Joining us now is Representative Jeff Duncan. Congressman, why is it so important to prevent these recess appointments?
Well, in South Carolina, we know very well what happens when you get a guy like Craig Becker as head of the NLRB, suing Boeing, suing South Carolina, Utah, Arizona, and South Dakota over a card check and the right to a secret ballot. And so the president is just basically usurping a congressional authority of being able to affirm and confirm his appointments.
All right, Congressman, tell us what you did over this weekend, the 4th of July weekend. You spent time on the Hill. In fact, you were on the House floor. Why did you do that?
Well, I came in the House floor today, and I actually acted as Speaker pro tempore to gavel the House into session so that we are in session. One body is not allowing the other body to recess. We're there. We're telling the Senate they have to be here as well. We're not going to let them recess, and basically to keep the president from being able to have the opportunity to appoint recess appointments.
Now, sir, I'm looking at the list. Mr. Obama has appointed 28 recess appointments so far in the 2.5 years he's been president. I look back, and the way it looks to me, Mr. Bush, President George W. Bush, made only 23 in 8 years as president. Is there any indication that this is the way Mr. Obama wants to start appointing posts to his White House?
Well, I think it is. I think he's trying to usurp the congressional authority as laid out in the Constitution, and the Senate does confirm all those appointments. But we've also seen what he's done with the special advisor to the president or the czars, the number of czars he has there, these type recess appointments. He's trying to bypass Congress, and I think that's wrong.
And now it's very important. The NLRB case against Boeing right now has a skew. It has a liberal skew to it. The board has a liberal skew. Isn't that right? Because of one of these recess appointments, Craig Becker, you point out. But that brought that board to a 3-to-1, I guess, union favoring liberal skew. Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. And you look at everything that they're doing, not just the Boeing case, but everything the NLRB is doing, and they're definitely supporting big labor. And the folks in a right-to-work state of South Carolina understand that that is just anti-American, and it's wrong for putting Americans back to work. And that's really what it's all about, is growing the economy, putting Americans back to work. And we see them sue a company like Boeing. We're going to fight back.
All right, Congressman, before we let you go, can you tell us where the Boeing case stands?
Right now, it's in the courts, but I can tell you that the South Carolina delegation, our senators, all the congressmen, especially the 4 freshman congressmen from South Carolina this year, our governor, we're all fighting this case as hard as we can.
All right, that's Representative Jeff Duncan, the Republican from South Carolina. Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you all.